So finally, we want to talk a little bit about how processes and shells interact. So a shell is an interactive application level program that launches other programs. And in fact, you've been using a shell all semester because when you type commands on Stu and you get responses, the shell is what is facilitating that. If you haven't selected a different shell, and if you don't know how to do that, then that's fine. It means that you're using the default one on Stu, which is a shell called Bash, B-A-S-H. So this is a program that takes your commands and launches other processes. And sometimes it's a single process, and sometimes it's a group of process. But these are, anytime you do this, this is called a job. And we'll talk a little bit more next time about why we might want to spawn multiple processes at the same time so that they can communicate with each other. There is a distinction between foreground and background jobs. So by default, programs and jobs are run in the foreground, and there's a single active foreground job at any given time, which is the job that you are interacting with while the program is running. But you could have jobs running in the background as well while you're interacting with the foreground job. And so this is something that's useful, and so you might want to start playing around with this some. So if you want to start a program that is going to be running in the background, you can do that by adding an ampersand at the end of the command. But probably what's a little more useful to you, at least in this course and the other systems courses, is to be able to take a program that is running in the foreground and turn it into a background job temporarily so that you can run something else. So this is useful, for instance, if you're in your text editor and you have everything set up the way that you want, and you just want to kind of you duck out for a couple of minutes to run a command, maybe a make or a make test or something like that. And so you can do that by pressing Control Z, and that will suspend the current foreground job and make it a background job. This will return you to the command line for your shell so that you can type in another command. And if you want to go back, once you've run the command, you can return the background job to the foreground using the FG command, and that will take whatever you had pressed Control Z in before and make it a foreground interactive job again. You can also use Control C to interrupt the foreground job, so this is something you've probably used already to interrupt unresponsive programs or infinite loops in your program. So how does this actually work? So it turns out that shells use the fork system command in order to run commands. So when you type a command into the shell, it's using the fork system call to create a new process. And then it's using the execve system call to execute your new program in that forked process. So you really end up starting with a copy of the shell process, and then it begins executing your program. And so here's a little snippet of code, which is actually going to give you a little bit of information here to illustrate how you can run another program using the fork and execve commands. So at this point, you could basically write your own shell if you wanted, because you could read in data from the user, and then you could fork and use execve to run a new process. And in some courses, this is an exercise. The students write their own shell program. We're not doing that in this course, but it would be an interesting and potentially fun exercise if this is the sort of thing that you're interested in. So Linux provides a couple of tools for monitoring processes on the system. Some of these you may have already run into as a part of just being a good user of Stu. So PS is a tool that you can use to list all the processes that are running on the system. So you can see all the processes, or you can just see the processes that are associated with your username. And it's good to, you know, check this occasionally to make sure that you don't have any runaway processes that are running sort of without, they're not doing anything useful for you. They're maybe just old editor processes that got stuck. Maybe your terminal crashed or something like that. You can also use a command called top, which lists all the processes on the system, but ordered by current CPU. And this one sort of live updates. It kind of takes over your terminal and it just continually updates with the most CPU intensive processes that are running on the system. So this is useful for determining, if a machine is running slow, this is useful for determining what processes or users may be responsible for slowing the machine down. Like I said, this does take over your terminal, and so if you want to quit this, you can do so using the Q key. There are some other facilities as well that Linux provides for managing processes, such as the slash /proc file system, the pmap, and the strace utilities. We won't be using these much this semester, but if you're interested in this, I would encourage you to look into them.